Hello friends, welcome in Bangej Math Academy. In previous video, we have learned practice set 4.1. In this video, we are going to study practice set 4.2. Let's start. Geometric construction. Practice set 4.2. See first example. Construct a tangent to a circle with center P and radius 3.2 cm at any point M on it. Radius of the circle is 3.2 cm. With the help of ruler, take distance in your compass 3.2 cm. Center of the circle is point P. We take radius in compass 3.2 cm. Put still point of compass on point P and draw a circle with radius 3.2 cm. Then we have to draw tangent to the circle at any point M on it. So take a point M on it. Then draw radius PM and extend it to right hand side. Radius is 3.2 cm. Then we have to draw tangent at point M. So take suitable distance in your compass and put still point of compass on point M and draw arcs to left and to right side of point M intersecting ray PM. Then we have to draw perpendicular bisector. So take further apart half than distance between these two arcs in your compass and put still point on one arc and draw arc to the upper and to lower side. Keeping the distance same, put still point on another point of intersection of arc and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then join this with the help of ruler. We draw tangent to the circle passing through point M. Second example, draw circle of radius 2.7 cm. Draw tangent to the circle at any point on it. So radius of the circle is 2.7 cm. Take distance in your compass 2.7 cm. take center of the circle as O, and we take distance between your compass 2.7 cm. Then push till point of compass on point O. Draw a circle with radius 2.7 cm. Then draw radius and extend it to right side. Radius of the circle is 2.7 cm. Take point M. Then we have to draw tangent through point M. Take suitable distance in compass and put still point on M and draw intersecting arc to ray OM to the left of point M and to the right side of point M. Then we have to draw perpendicular bisector of these two arcs. So take distance in your compass further apart half than these two arcs. Push till point on point of intersection of these arcs and draw arc to the upper side and to the lower side. Keeping the distance same, put still point on another point of intersection of arc and ray OM and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then join this with the help of ruler. We draw tangent to the circle through point M. Third example, draw a circle of radius 3.6 cm, draw a tangent to the circle at any point on it without using the center. In this example, we have to draw tangent to the circle without using the center. So first of all, draw a circle with radius 3.6 cm. Take distance in your compass 3.6. Take distance in your compass 3.6 cm. Take point P as the center and draw a circle with radius 3.6. We have to draw tangent to the circle without using the center. So draw a chord AB and take any point on the circle to the center side. Then join segment AM and segment MB. We have to draw tangents to the circle without using the center. So we can draw tangent to the circle passing through point B and also point A. So, to draw the tangent without using center, they are using tangent second theorem or angles in alternate segment. Take this suitable distance in your compass, put still point on point M and draw arc like this. Then, keeping the distance same, put still point on point B and draw intersecting arc to side AB and its lower side. Then, take distance in your compass, keeping the distance same, put still point on this point and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then, with the help of ruler, join point B and this point of intersection. We draw tangent to the circle without using the center of the circle. Fourth example, draw a circle of radius 3.3 cm, draw a chord PQ of length 6.6 cm, draw tangent to the circle at point P and Q, write your observation about the tangents. First of all, draw a circle with radius 3.3 cm. Take distance in your compass 3.3 cm. Take point O as the center of the circle and draw circle with radius 3.3 cm. Radius of the circle is 3.3 cm and we have to draw chord PQ of length 6.6 cm. So, 6.6 is twice the 3.3, means diameter is twice the radius. So, chord PQ is a diameter. So, draw chord PQ passing through the center of the circle and extend to the left and right side. Then we have to draw tangent to the circle at point P and Q. So take suitable distance in your compass. Put still point of compass on point P and draw intersecting arc to left and to right side of this line. Then, with same distance, put still point on point Q and draw intersecting arc to left and right side. Then, we have to draw perpendicular bisectors between these two arcs. So, take distance between your compass further apart half than these two arcs. Put till point on this point and draw arc to the upper and to the lower side. Keeping the distance same, put till point on this point and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then, keeping the distance same, put till point on this point and draw arcs to the upper and to lower side. Then, put still point on this point and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then join this with the help of ruler. Radius is perpendicular to tangent. So OQ is perpendicular to this tangent and OP is perpendicular to this tangent. So these two tangents are parallel tangents. Tangents to the circle at point P and Q are parallel tangents. We can write in this way. Write down your observation. So tangents at point P and Q are parallel to each other. Fifth example, draw a circle with radius 3.4 centimeter. Draw chord MN of length 5.7 cm in it. Construct tangents at points M and N to the circle. Take distance in your compass as 3.4 cm. Then take point P and put still point of compass on point P and draw a circle with radius 3.4 centimeter. Radius of this circle is 3.4 centimeter. Then draw chord MN of length 5.7 centimeter. So take point M on the circle. We have to draw chord of length 5.7 centimeter. Then take distance in your compass 5.7 centimeter. Put still point on point M and draw intersecting arc to the circle. So we get the position of point N. So we get point N. Then join this with the help of ruler. We have to draw tangents at point M and N to the circle. So draw radius PN and extend to the outer side and also draw radius PM and extend it to the outer side. Then see, take suitable distance in your compass, put still point on point M, draw arc to the left and to the right side intersecting ray PM. With same distance, put still point on point N and we can draw intersecting arc to ray PN. Then take further apart half than distance between these two arcs, put still point on this point and draw arc to the upper and to the lower side. Keeping the distance same, put still point on this point and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. we have to draw two tangents at point M and N. So do same procedure. Push till point on this side and draw arc to the upper and to the lower side. Then keeping the distance same, draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then join this with the help of ruler. Radius is perpendicular to tangent and draw, join this with the help of ruler. Radius is perpendicular to tangent. So we draw tangent to the circle at point M and N. Sixth example, draw a circle with center P and radius 3.4 cm. Take point Q at a distance 5.5 cm from the center. Construct tangent to the circle from point Q. Draw a circle with radius 3.4 cm. Take point P as the center of the circle and draw a circle with radius 3.4. Radius of the circle is 3.4 cm. Then take point Q at a distance of 5.5 cm from the center. So draw radius and extend it to the right side to locate the position of point Q on this ray. Then we have to locate the position of point Q, which is at distance of 5.5 cm from the center of the circle. See, we take distance in compass as 5.5 cm and point Q is at a distance of 5.5 cm from the center. So draw intersecting arc to this ray. So we get point Q. Then we have to draw tangent to the circle from point Q. So draw perpendicular bisector of segment PQ. Take further apart half than distance between PQ in your compass and put still point on point Q. Draw arc to the upper and to the lower side, keeping the distance same. Put still point of compass on point P. Draw intersecting arc to previous arc and join this point of intersection of arcs with the help of ruler. We draw perpendicular to ray PQ. Then suppose at this point take as a M. Then take a radius as MP or MQ, one and the same. Take a radius as MP and draw intersecting arcs to this circle as radius M, and we can draw a circle also like this. Then with the help of ruler, draw tangents through point Q. See, we draw tangent to the circle, point lies outside the circle. So we can draw two tangents to the circle through a point outside lies in it. Seventh example, draw a circle with radius 4.1 cm. Construct tangent to the circle from a point at a distance 7.3 cm from the center. So we have to draw tangent to the circle from exterior point. Take distance in your compass 4.1 cm, and center of the circle is point P. Point P as a center, draw a circle with radius 4.1 cm. Radius of the circle is 4.1 cm. Then take point at 7.3 cm from the center. So draw radius and extend to the right side. We have to locate the position of point at 7.3. So take distance in your compass 7.3 cm in your compass and put still point on point P and draw intersecting arc to this ray. So we get the position of point P, which lies at a distance of 7.3 cm. Suppose point Q. Then draw perpendicular bisector of segment PQ. Take further apart half than the distance between PQ and draw arc to the upper and to the lower side. Keeping the distance same, put still point of compass on point P and draw intersecting arc to previous arc. Then join these point of intersection of arcs with the help of ruler. Take point M. Then in compass, M as a center and MP as a radius, or MQ as a radius. Put still point on point M and draw intersecting arcs to the circle like this. Then join point Q and point of intersection of arcs and circle with the help of ruler. Hence we completed practice set 4.2 of geometric construction. In next video we will see problem set of geometric construction. So please like, share, comment the video, and to get the notifications of new videos, subscribe Bangiz Math Academy and press the bell icon. Thank you.